Hello everyone, I'm Joseph and today I'm going to talk to you about credit cards. Three things. One, how do credit cards work? Secondly, should you get a credit card? And thirdly, what are the benefits? What are the disadvantages? And what are the best practices so that you don't fall into a cycle of debt with a credit card? Let's look at the first one. How do credit cards work? Credit cards are supposed to debit cards in which if you have a debit card, you spend money that you already have in your bank account. With a credit card, like the name suggests, it's given as a loan to you. Now, what's the difference between a loan and a credit card? One is that the loan interest, for example, if you take a personal loan, you would be charged somewhere around 10 to 11% annually. But in the case of a credit card, you're going to be charged 3 to 4% per month, which puts you somewhere close to 40% per year. Right, so as you can imagine, credit card interest rates are way higher than other loan interest rates like your personal loan. So for that reason, be very careful not to get into the cycle where you cannot pay back the money. So that is how credit cards work. And there are two important things that you need to know about credit card. One is statement date. The second one is due date. Now, what are those two dates? So when you get a credit card, let's assume that your statement date is on the 13th of every month. So let's say June 13th, you get a statement from the bank for the last 30 days of the expenses incurred in your credit card. Now, the statement date is June 13th. So typically 20 days from that is your due date, which is July 3rd. So what that means is, let's say if you spent 20,000 rupees between May 13th and June 13th, on June 13th, you'll get a statement that you have spent 20,000 and your due date is July 3rd. And if you can pay back that 20,000 before July 3rd, then there are no interests charged, so you are scot-free. So basically you use 20,000 bucks, which you might or might not have had at that time, but still you don't have to pay any interest. So that is why credit cards are useful and that is how credit cards work. Secondly, should you get a credit card? Now that totally depends on your personal financial discipline. Can you pay back on time? Are you a person who spends more than what you earn? Then it's an absolute no. Do not get into a credit card. If you're a person who's very hopeful that, okay, I'm going to spend a lot of money now, but eventually I'll get it so I can pay back. If you are that kind of a person, don't get into a credit card. But if you are a person who has a personal financial discipline, if you budget every month and you always spend less than what you have, or what you earn, then credit card is a good thing for you. But also, one other thing I would say is you can definitely get a credit card, because just by having a credit card, you don't have to necessarily use it all the time. But it does come handy during emergencies. For example, your credit limit is 1 lakh. And if there is any sort of untoward emergency for which a medical expense you have to, suddenly pay, say, 75,000, you can definitely use a credit card to get that, to pay that 75,000 to any hospital. The other good thing about credit card is that whole statement date and the due date. Say you incurred this 75,000 on May 15th in an hospital. And the statement for that is going to come on June 13th, because 13th is the statement date, like I mentioned. So June 13th, you're going to get a statement saying that you need to pay back the bank 75,000. Now you have 20 extra days. So that means July 3rd is the due date for that 75,000. Now, as you can imagine, between May 15th and July 3rd, there are two paychecks. So you might eventually have that money to pay back the bank without incurring any interest on the loan that you got in the credit card. So that is why I recommend that you have a credit card. Thirdly, what are the perks, benefits, disadvantages of having a credit card? First and foremost, let's talk about the positive things. Credit cards can give you a lot of points. So every time you swipe a card, you get points added to your account. Now these points themselves do not have any monetary value, but you can go to your credit card provider website and you can redeem things with these points. Now when I say things, there are really great things like you could get good headphones, you could get a mic, you could get a watch, something for the kitchen, something for the house, you could get gift vouchers, etc. So there are a lot of things, and these things differ based on the credit card provider that you have. So that's one definite perk, which is the reward point that you get. Secondly, there could be cashbacks. For example, there are credit cards that will give you 2% cashback on any expense that you incur. What that means is if you spend, say 50,000 on something, then 1,000 rupees is given back to you as a cashback, right? So that is a great benefit to have. So those are, again, these benefits vary from credit card provider to provider. So that's something that you really have to ask your credit card provider, what kind of benefits do you get? Those are the good things about credit card. What are the bad things about credit card? There could be hidden charges. For example, there could be annual maintenance charge of 2,000, 4,000 rupees or 600 rupees, depending on the card that you have, that you might be charged. So please ensure before getting a credit card that there are no annual fees, because there are a lot of credit cards out there that provide you zero annual fees for credit cards. So ask the right questions when you're getting the credit card. Ask about the benefits. Ask about this particular thing about zero annual maintenance cost, and then you sign up for a card. The other bad thing is if you get into a debt, that becomes a problem. When I say debt, what I mean is if you're not able to pay within the due date, that is a big no-no. Do not get a credit card if you cannot pay the money back within the due date, because like I said, the interest rates are very, very high and they're charged monthly. So be very, very careful of that. The third thing is best practices. So what are the best practices? So one of the best practices that I've been following, and it's really helped me, is to have an auto debit facility set up for your credit card. And also, you can decide the statement date and the due date for your card, and you can change it once. So when you get your card, by default, there will be a particular statement date and due date, and you can change it once after to a due date that is convenient to you. Now, what I mean by that is that, you know, in our previous example, the statement date was 13th of a month and the due date is the 3rd of the next month, right? Now, it depends on when you get your paycheck. The best practice here is that ensure that your due date is 3 to 4 days or 5 days even after your salary date. So if you are a person who gets your salary on the 25th or the, you know, last Friday of a month or something, then it's best to have the due date set to 2nd or 3rd of the next month, right? The reason is that if your due date is after your salary, right after your salary day, that means you have money to pay back the credit card, because credit card debt is one of the worst debts. Again, I want to emphasize that the interest rates of credit card is way high. So please ensure that you pay back on time. So I hope this video was helpful. If you did like it, please share it with your friends. And in the comments, you can ask any questions related to credit cards, and I'll be more than happy to answer you.